Today we're going to discuss ozone ear insufflations. If you want more information on ozone, go ahead and check out our Basics of Ozone Therapy video linked in the description below. For this video, we're going to assume you already know about ozone. Ear insufflations are a method of delivering ozone at a safe concentration into the ear canal. This is often considered for people who experience brain fog, neurological issues, eye conditions, ear problems, sinus issues, or for improving mental clarity. You'll need a high purity oxygen source, an ozone generator, a water bubbler humidifier combo, and an ear scope. First, hook up your oxygen to the ozone generator. If you've never done this, check out our setup video linked in the description. Once it's set up, turn the oxygen flow to 1/8 liters per minute. Now you'll set the dial on your ozone generator. It's recommended to start with low amounts of ozone until you know how it will affect you. A popular output is 20 to 40 gamma. To get this using our O3 Elite single, set the dial between 1 and 4. Consult the output chart that came with your machine to determine your chosen setting. You need an adjustable ozone machine in order to have the flexibility needed to obtain the proper output for your needs and to lessen the amount of ozone dispersed into the room while doing an insufflation. Now you hook up the humidifier. The benefit of using a humidifier is that it will add some moisture to the ozone so it will be less drying. This combo unit is recommended because it comes with a destruct filter system. If you're using a PromoLife ozone generator, you won't need to worry about sound. But with other machines, the bubbler helps muffle the loud noises coming from the generator, which is especially helpful for people with sensitive hearing. For more information on how to set up the water bubbler humidifier combo, check out the setup video linked in the description. Once it's hooked up, make sure the dial on the filter system is set like this to filter the ozone. Attach a piece of tubing to the side port of the filter system if it is not already installed and attach the other end to the ear scope. Use distilled water in the humidifier and make sure the diffuser is fully covered. Once the oxygen and ozone are turned on to the right flow rates and settings, you will see bubbling in the water bubbler. Allow the water to saturate with ozone for 5 to 10 minutes. After that, place the ear scope on your head and make sure the earbuds are not fully pushed into the ears. You want them loosely placed so air can enter and exit easily. Then turn the switch on the filter system to direct ozone to the ear scope. You may feel a slight warmth when ozone exits the earbuds. This is normal and will only last a few seconds. Continue with the insufflation for the recommended time, which can be anywhere from 2 to 10 minutes. Once you're done, switch the filter dial back like this to turn off the flow and remove the ear scope. Then turn off your ozone generator, followed by your oxygen source. That's it. The first thing many people notice after an ear insufflation is more clearness in the head and better breathing. You might feel some irritation and a slight itchiness in the ears, which is totally normal. Some might experience some ear discharge, which is usually caused by doing the insufflation too long or with too high an ozone concentration. To remedy this, reduce the time and concentration. As long as you don't experience irritation, you can do ear insufflations every other day or as directed by your health practitioner. If you like this video or would like more information on ozone, visit our videos page or our YouTube channel. Subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell to be informed when we upload new videos. For more information on PromoLife's ozone therapy generators, glassware, and accessories, visit www.promolife.com.